Hi guys, how are you doing? This is Jamal from Aviation Guide Channel. You know, to set up an airplane takes some time. The initial step is called preliminary preflight procedure. Today, I'm gonna show you guys how to perform it as a professional pilot. If you are ready, let's get started. Hi guys, welcome to Aviation Guide Channel. This is Jamal. Today we are with this Boeing 777 trainer ER extended range version on X-Plane 11 with a package of FF 777 professional. With the outlook of Boeing 777, what we see here is the ground power units are connected, food truck is here, call bus is here, chucks are in place, doors are opened. So I like this simulator, I like it very much, but there are some obscurities, uncertainties, which, for example, you know, the stair is located from my perspective now on the left side, on the first officer side, but normally it should have been on the right side, the captain side for passenger boarding and so as COBAS. And there are many, not too much, correction, not too many, but I mean, there are a number of those kind of obscurities in the simulator. So forgive me for those ones. I will try to explain you guys comparing normal operations and the simulator, right? Our stand number is Sierra 402. Today I'm going to show you guys how to do the preliminary preflight procedure as a pilot. Let's taking the charge. Now, you see, this is the general appearance when we step in the cockpit. For preliminary preflight procedures, when we step in the cockpit here, there must be gear pins, 5 gear pins. We are checking that they are located. Then we are having seat. Then the captain takes a look at the cockpit book, which is a technical logbook, which consists of our malfunctions, ADDs, MDDs, maintenance, deferred defects, aircraft deferred defects, and the other malfunctions, and the aircraft's information about the last sectors, especially last 10 sectors. And after taking a look at the aircraft logbook, the first officer is cleared by the captain for preliminary preflight procedure, guys. The first thing is to putting the aider on. Here there must be Wi-Fi and antenna switches. Those are on. Cockpit voice recorder button switches on. Otherwise, if we forget it, it is it places on when one of the engines are started. An emergency light is on. And then we are taking a look at the status page, which is appeared, which appears on the lower DU. Here we see the oxygen pressure. If below 1100 psi, we are checking performance dispatch for actual requirement. For ETOP sectors, the minimum is 1100 psi. Other than that, it is related with the temperature. Hydraulic quantity. Quantity now shows zero, but there is a mistake here. Normally it shows, between 90, 100. The maximum value, as far as I remember, is 106, and the minimum is 76. If it is below 76, it shows RF refill. And engine, and we are not checking engine oil. engine oil quantity 17. When serviced by engineer, oil quantity will be sufficient for at least 20 hours flight time. And then, guys, as a first officer, we are doing the remaining actions after one crew change or maintenance action. And now we are checking on the right side here. There must be a torch light. It must be flashing once every 4 seconds. And then we are checking the aircraft documents. We are stepping back and have a seat here. There must be a certificates and the documents here. We are checking the aircraft radio station license, certificate of airworthiness, airworthiness review certificate, certificate of insurance, maintenance statements, certificate of registration, noise certification. We are checking dent and buckle chart. This gives us a clue. Whoever is about to do the exterior inspection, it gives us a clue to check those dents and buckles. An aircraft library. We are checking the updated documents if they're on board or not. Emergency equipment, fire extinguisher. We are checking expire date on the validity display. Crash X is here. Two escape ropes, smoke hood escape ropes are here, left side and right side also. And then what we are checking is the smoke hood PBs in case of smoke exposure, fire gloves for life vests, two emergency crew flashlights, as I told you before. For the passenger typed aircraft like this, Boeing 777-ER, you see, we are checking the door if it is operable. We are supposed to perform the security check here. We are now checking everywhere if something bad is, something dangerous is located or hidden. Everywhere, this draws sections here also, pedestal and the underneath of the chairs, floor areas, seat like jackets, pockets underneath seats, as I told you before, storage compartments. And then as a preliminary pre-flight procedure, cargo temperature selectors must be low just in case. I mean, low gives us around 7 degrees Celsius, a high approximately 21 degrees Celsius, but low, low section is a default one. But if we have a NOTOC, notification to captain, paper, I mean, if we will carry a live dog or live pet or flowers which has sensitivity to temperature, we have to adjust those temperatures correctly for aft and bulk and for the forward cargo temperature as well. Here we see flight deck temperature, cabin temperature. We are doing that auto, which gives us approximately 24 degrees Celsius. All right, guys, then we are checking the circuit breakers here. If some of them are tripped, we call maintenance because still not, engines are not working. And parking brake, set as needed. That's it, guys. This is the preliminary pre-flight procedure. Normally it takes maximum 2-3 minutes to perform the procedure, but it took almost 12 minutes for you guys to explain a little bit.
Thank you for watching the video. Stay tuned for the next episodes. Take care.